Hi, Fatima, how are you?
How are you?
I'm doing great. So, what time is it there right now? Midnight?
Oh, yeah, midnight.
Okay, well, I'll try to make this as quick as humanly possible so you can sleep kind of well, all right?
Okay.
So basically, the first thing I wanted to ask you was, other than hi, and I'm so glad to meet you finally, is so how was your week last week? And just in terms of, everything went amazing from the basketball game to the practice to the game. Can you kind of just walk me through what the experience like for you?
Okay, first of all, I just got the schedule and I didn't know what I was expecting. So once I saw the schedule, so I was reading one by one, I'm like, oh my God, no way. No way, this is not happening. This is not happening. So I didn't believe anything, so I said, till I get there, then maybe it's true. So I was kind of nervous and I was like giving hard time to my friends because I was so nervous and freaking out. They're like, just calm down, you'll enjoy it and relax, everything will be fine. And I was just freaking out all over them. I'm like, please bear with me till I get over this week and everything will be fine. So
I remember a moment when you were about to do the face off. I saw you did a move in your face when I get nervous, which was like kind of like close your eyes and scrunch up a little bit before you started walking. Like what was that experience like to just walk in front of like 18,000 people? And then on top of that, everyone knew who you were because the stick handling thing went viral beforehand.
actually, I was freaking out. Like, literally every day, I was freaking out. Like, tomorrow I'm gonna do this. Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. And I'm glad that I picked my brother to come with me. Like, I had so many friends. They're like, just take us, just take us. I'm like, if my brother finishes his visa, I'm gonna take my brother. Because I know he's been there for me the whole time. And he's gonna support me. So I just told him, just remind me to breathe so I don't just talk to death. And he's been there telling me every day, just breathe, breathe, calm down, everything's gonna be fine. And my other friends have been texting me, just relax, everything is going to be okay. So, like, day by day, like, the first day, it wasn't much, it's just arriving there. Second day, like, they made a full schedule for me. So, the second day was sightseeing, so we just went around the city, museum. Saw all the monuments and Lincoln statue, and then walked by the White House and then back to the hotel. We got picked up at 4 to go to the basketball game, so they took us to the players' benches. So I was talking to my brother, I'm like, oh my God, we're sitting on the players' seat, this is unbelievable. And then we were just watching the players, and suddenly they came to us, like, do you know LeBron? Of course, I know LeBron. Like, do you want to see him? Sure, just I want to see him. So they took me to the other side to watch him. So I was like, wow, he's huge. And then
You made a basket too. I saw a video of you just casually walking out in the court and making a shot.
yeah, I think it was a lucky. I haven't played basketball in years. So then they just told us that we're gonna sit in the front row seat. So I'm like, oh my God, this is not happening. Like, I don't expect any of this. So it's just surprises behind the surprises. It was just crazy. Watching that game, it was an insane game. Like, they told me it was one of the best games in the season. So I'm like, okay, we're so lucky to watch that game.
Yeah,
So
the Wizards have been very good the last 2 months, but I know like the Wizards kind of didn't have a ton of respect, and then they played that game, and taking the defending champions to the wire like that, it was insane. Like I turned it on late towards the end of the fourth quarter, and I was just like, and I was like, Fatima's getting to see
yeah,
this.
exactly. The fourth quarter was like unbelievable, especially the last few seconds when LeBron tied the games. It was like insane. It was a great game to watch.
Yeah, you got, I don't want to say lucky, but I think the stars aligned for you. And then let's see, the next day you got to go to practice, right?
No, the next day it was a visit to the embassy. and then watch Caps Hurricanes game. So we went to the embassy, we met the ambassador. It was really great to meet him. He's a really great guy. He's into sports, so I didn't expect that he's that much into sports. It was impressive how much he knows about every team in Washington and how they're doing. So it was great talking to him about sports and stuff. And then we went to the Verizon Center, and Peter met us there, and he told us that Peter and Lee, they told us, I'm going to get the glass seat. So I'm like, no way. They're like, yes, you're going to sit down. I'm like, no way. This is unbelievable.
What was it like to see it so close? Because, you know, I know you play, but when you see NHL players at first down on ice level, it blows you away how fast they are.
Yeah, because that was my first proper hockey game, so I haven't seen, like, any proper games, like, with a decent... I've seen decent level, but not this high level. So, but just Peter took us to watch the warm-up, and the first thing is I contacted Backstrom.
Yeah.
Nicky, he just waved at me, so I opened my eyes. Is he waving at me? So I was shocked. And then he waved back. Like, yes, he's waving at me. So I waved back and I was, like, shocked. I didn't expect anyone to, like, know me or realize that I'm there. And then Peter asked if one of the players can, like, give us a puck. So Orlov just threw a puck over the glass to us. And aww. I was so happy with that puck.
That's so cool. So how did you know Backstrom beforehand?
Actually, I know most of the team.
Yeah.
But I was more excited. Like when I came back home, I'm like, why I didn't talk to the rest of the players? It's like I didn't have time. They didn't have time for me because like it was tight and everyone have other things to do. So I just wanted to talk to each and every player, but I didn't get the chance to talk to all of them except Ovi, Backstrom, Oshie a little bit in the locker room, Wilson, Williams. They're awesome guys. They're amazing.
Yeah, one thing that I always hear, you know, in times past, I haven't heard this with the team, but the Caps are really like a close family, and especially this year, it just like every player, like during the bye week, I'm sure you've seen, is that most of the players are vacationing together. I mean, I've never seen anything like that before where they're just all such close friends. So, let's see. So you ended up, I guess we can fast forward to after the game, right? So you went down. How did you first, I guess I should ask this first, is how did you first ended up falling in love with the Capitals? And how did you first end up loving Ovi so much?
It's kind of a funny story. When I started hockey, I like to look for someone who I look up to. Mm-hmm. So I just try to become like them or just take their style of playing.
Mm-hmm.
So I was looking into two players. It was even Crosby or Ovi. It was a tough choice. And then I asked a few coaches around and asked a few players around, and they're like, none of them are helping, so like I'm going to do my own research about both of the players. So I loved that time to score goals. So I was looking for someone who can score goals and like know how to score goals. So both of them are great players. And then when I saw Ovi just scoring goals, amazing goals, and going through players and everything, so I'm like, wow, he's my man. I got to watch him. He's my... I'll be keeping up with this guy. So I've been watching his highlights, the Caps highlights and everything since like now for 5 years almost.
Oh, that's amazing.
And like it's been amazing. Like, too bad they get to the playoffs, they don't get to the Stanley Cup. It's just sad.
Well, maybe you're their good luck charm.
I hope this year they're going to get there. And I told them if they get to the playoffs or Stanley Cup, I'll do my best to come there, at least to watch one game and come back home.
Oh, my gosh.
I hope we can make it.
You can definitely crash at my house if you need a place to stay, okay?
Thanks.
For free. Though I'm sure they'll take care of you.
Thanks.
So when you first went down the locker room, so you go, the best part for me when I saw that was just your face when you first saw Ovechkin, which was, and I'm going to try and imitate it. So how did that go? And like a week later, like, can you even believe that it just happened?
Not really, because the locker room wasn't on the schedule. Like, I wasn't supposed to meet the team till the next day, after practice. So I was like, I think, like, it was just a thought. I was talking to my brother. I'm like, it's better to watch, to see the players, to meet them before going on the ice with them. Otherwise, I'll faint on the ice or strip on my face. And I don't want that to happen.
That's true.
Yeah, of course. You don't want to be embarrassed. Like, oh, she's good, and then boom, on your face.
So what did he tell you when you first saw him, if you can remember? I mean, I know it's been a long time.
What happened is I watched two periods by the glass, and then they told me the third period is we'll take you to the owner suite because Ted wants to meet you and wants to meet you. So we went upstairs. And while we were going upstairs, they asked me, do you want to go to the locker room to meet the players? So I was like, like, I just paused for 5 minutes. And then the Lee told me, he's like, I assume that's a yes. So I'm like, yes, why not? So we just went, just 1 second.
Sure.
Sorry.
I like how I'm getting a tour. Oh, sorry, my bad.
Not an issue. My mom sleeps too early, so.
I say the same thing about my wife too. So don't worry. Sometimes she goes to bed before Caps games are over, and I'm like, no.
Well, what happened afterward, then we went up for the game, and then the game ended 5-0, so we're so happy that they won.
Yeah.
And I was like, time to go to the locker room. So I was like, breathe, just keep on breathing. So every step I took closer to the locker room, I got more nervous. And then I think the first person who we saw is the goalie's coach, and then after, when the first player I saw was Carl. So, he's so sweet.
Yes.
Like, he's so nice. He's like, oh, come in. This is our locker room, and you can do whatever. Just walk around, check out. I'm like, oh my God, this is insane. So we went inside, and then I don't remember who's the second player we saw, because it was jammed with media. And I don't remember much. I think, yeah, Backstrom, he came up to me. And he's like, I waved at you. Did you see me? I told him, yes, I saw you. But I wasn't sure if you were waving at me. He started laughing. He's like, can I have a hug? I'm like, of course, why not? He was so nice. He's a sweetheart. And then Ted took me to introduce me to one of the players. I can't recall who. So we were just talking, and suddenly he told me, oh, come, let me introduce you to Alex. So I got that face on my, you saw the picture, how I looked,
yeah.
The shock, the reaction. And then I wasn't shocked because I saw Ovi, it's like Oshi with him, so I'm like, oh my God, both of them are there, not only one, this is insane, this is not happening. So I just started shaking, so just trying to calm down, I couldn't. So it was just, I don't know how I felt. It was just filled with emotions. And I just was just trying to stay calm, don't faint, don't cry. I'm like, just breathe. Till he goes, then you can do whatever you want.
You know,
so I just kept on breathing, and I was shaking so much. Then he said, let's take a picture. And I don't know if you saw the video. I told him, I'm sorry, I'm shaking. He said, it's okay, and he started laughing.
I'm sure that happens for him a lot.
it, was insane. It's like your dream is coming true and you see your favorite player that you never expect that you're going to see in your whole life in front of you. So
it's so weird,
I don't know.
Because you're used to seeing them on TV and they're like almost like a fictitious thing, you know? And then, hey, they're right in your face and they're actually a human being and they're actually good at hockey just like you are. And, you know, they're all real people. It's always, when I first started doing RMNB, I had the same thing. I'd go into the locker room and I'd be like, I shouldn't be here. You know what I mean? Like, this feels really weird. All these people are usually on TV and now they're right here just talking and taking their skates off. And I think, you know, it was so amazing, you know, to just see your reactions and see how humble you were about the whole thing. I think that's why people just enjoyed the whole experience so much, was just to see how happy you were. It was amazing. And on top of that, it taught so many people a good lesson that really hockey, and not only hockey, but America, is for everybody. And I think, you know, that week was like, even like I got like a little choked up at times just watching it. I know. So the next night you go to the game. I don't want to skip over the practice. We will get to that. But I know that the next night, even the PA announcer, the guy who announced you coming onto the ice, Wes Johnson, had an incredibly sweet way of introducing you. And it was just really, really, the whole moment was just so powerful. Like, even for me, sitting at home, just watching it, my mouth was agape. Like, I just can't believe this is happening. It is, because it really symbolized a lot more than just you as a human being there. It really symbolized a lot, because I think even in North America, for instance, you know, they have a women's hockey league that just started a year ago. But just to see that the sport is starting to take off, you know, in more of a desert country out in the Arab world, I mean, it's just, it's incredible, you know?
Yeah, it is kind of weird. Like, when you say we play hockey in the U.S., like, we play in the desert. Yeah, we do play in the desert. We have one ice rink close to the desert. So, yeah, it is kind of crazy. Because it's been spreading around, like, really fast all around the world. Like, we have here UAE, Qatar, Oman, Bahrain, Kuwait. All of them, they're playing, they have ice rinks. They're playing now, I think, two or three teams are in the Winter Olympics in Singapore.
Oh, wow.
Now.
Wow.
They just traveled. Yeah, we have the Asian Winter Olympics going on next week. And, like, most of the teams are already there. Our national team traveled yesterday, and they arrived today. And I wish them all the best luck. I wish I was there with them. I was planning to go, but I have my own tournament to get ready for.
That's so cool. Oh my gosh. Like, and that's the thing too, is I know that even a week before you were there, the Capitals were hosting a young Chinese team. And
yeah.
You know, China, they have teams in the KHL now, but but you can even see in the NBA how many NBA players come from there. It's just going to make the game, the, you know, hockey, even better as it grows globally. So, you know, it's so cool, you know, for me personally to see. And I do want to get back to the game when you're walking out. So how did the whole selfie thing come about? Because I have never seen, so for someone who was very, very nervous, that took a lot of confidence. And as we say in America, grapefruits. So
actually, I'm not a fan of taking selfies. Like, if whoever is following me, I don't take much selfies, but I like to take group selfies with friends, with family, but I don't like to take selfies of my own. So it's like, it's the thing back home. It's they call me like, oh, you have the longest arm, so you take the selfie. It's like, okay, never mind. Okay, I will take it. I was thinking of doing, I'm known back home for doing crazy stuff. So if you ask anyone around back home, they know that she's crazy. She does crazy stuff. So I was thinking, like, what can I do? I need to do something special. So I didn't have anything in mind till I got there. So I was like, I think my last option is to take a selfie. So I had my phone. I asked if I can do it. They told me, do whatever you want, but don't tell anyone.
That's good advice. If you ever ask for permission for something like that, because with the NHL, everything is so regimented, you know? Like every minute is planned out, especially before the game, that if you lengthen it by 10 seconds, you throw everything off. So that was great advice, whoever told you that.
So I said, okay, and I was mic'd up. So every time I get to the rink, I get mic'd up the whole day. So whoever was mic'd, I turned into him. I was like, you didn't hear anything. He's like, okay. Like, yep, that's exactly what I meant. So he just went quiet and he started laughing at me. So I just went there. The guy told me, the one who I told, that took permission from, he said, just keep your phone ready and make it quick. So I said, okay, no problem. I just turned on my camera, turned everything, just made it ready and kept it in my pocket. So I don't know if you noticed how fast I pulled my phone out of my pocket. I don't think anyone noticed unless you repeat the video more than one time.
It was.
You see how fast my phone came out.
I would have dropped my phone because I'd be shaking so much and I'd just start crying probably. That would probably how I would handle it, to be honest. The funniest part for me was when Zetterberg was like, he mouthed like selfie, and then Ovi was like, they just did it. I've never seen anything quite like that. So like, do you remember like anything else from that?
I know. See, do you know how I had my phone properly? It didn't fall out of my hand.
Yeah.
I have like a finger holder behind my phone.
That's smart. So that's smart.
That's the trick. So I just pulled the phone. So I said I'll ask them. Maybe they don't want to. It's fine. And I was glad they were fine with it, and they were into taking the picture. So it's like, okay.
And it turned out perfect. I mean, it was just amazing. And it got thousands of retweets. I mean, from millions of different accounts. Like, you were the most viewed person in the NHL that night. I can guarantee it.
Oh my God. That's insane.
Isn't that crazy? But I can say that with 100% confidence. I know that you were out there for warm-ups, too. It looked like the players just were gravitating towards you the entire time.
What gave me more goosebumps, like, beside the 18,000 people watching, is all the players were standing up and banging the board. So I was like, oh my god, this is insane. Like, what did I do in my life so I get all this?
Your stick handling is pretty freaking impressive. The other thing, too, was, like, when Peter Bondra, who was one of my personal heroes, growing up, I first started watching hockey when I was about 12, so in around 1996, and that's when Bondra was scoring like 50 goals a year, and it was very, you know, emotional for me too to see Banzai traveling over the world trying to expose the game to more people, and just for him to randomly put. How did those stick handling videos come about? Is that just how you roll in practice?
Yeah, actually, I just do this for fun. Like, I didn't expect, like, anyone is watching me or anything special, because even the coaches back home, they're used to it, because I have my stick all the time. Even one of the coaches, he called it my husband. So, like, yeah, you're husband. My first husband was in Easton, so broke. Now I have so many other sticks. So now they're my children's.
Mine is too right here. It's an Easton Stealth that Mike Green used to use.
My first stick that I broke, but I don't know where my mom put it. I have so many sticks in my home, so I don't know where it is. I need to find it somehow. So the whole thing was by coincidence. I did not expect anyone was watching me. Like, one of the coaches is like, I'll try my skate before the tournament, because the next day Bondra was playing and some of the ex-NHL players were there as well to play in the tournament.
Who else were there?
I told him, okay, I will check if I have my skates in the car so I can come on the ice.
Oh my God.
Unfortunately, I didn't have my skates, so I think if you saw in the video, I was with my slippers
Oh
standing on the
yeah.
ice. So I just picked up any stick from the men's locker room and was just passing the puck around. And there was another guy who was passing to him as well. So once he gets passing the puck with the other guy, I would just do the trick. Just practicing for fun. And then suddenly I see two camera guys behind me. So I turned back and like, okay, never mind. I just ignored them and kept on playing. And suddenly I see Bondra behind me. And I looked again and like, okay. And he's like, can you do this trick again? I'm like, yeah, I can do that. Just too much confidence. I don't know from where did that come. I didn't know Peter before that. Like once he stepped on the ice for the coaching, then the coaches started telling me that you have this guy, he got these points, and they told me about all the players are coming. So I was like, wow, this is amazing. I'd be more than happy just to say hello to them. So once he told me like, can you do this again? I'm like, oh, what am I doing wrong? Am I doing something wrong? He's like, okay, I'll do it again. I did it, and he was trying to take the video from the bench, so I couldn't see it much. So he's like, wait, I'll come on the ice. So he went on the ice. He just walked in front of me. He's like, do it again, do it again. So I took. He's like, can I take a video? He's like, sure, of course. He took a video and he's like, can I post it on Twitter? Like, yes, sure. And I don't think both of us knew that it will go this crazy and it will get that much of likes or retweets. And
Well,
then the next few days he came to me, he's like, did you see how much it got from likes and retweets? This is the first post that gets that much. It's like, I think, yeah, I did see it, and this is, I don't know what to say about it. It's just crazy. He's like, I want another video of you. Do you have or can you do any tricks? We were tight with ice time, so I showed him one of my old videos. It was during the summer holidays, just fooling around with the goalies. And he's like, yes, you send that to me, the cross move. And I sent it to him, and he posted, and it went crazy too.
Yeah,
And then he asked me to should
one of
go.
the reasons why it went crazy was just again because women in sports, especially hockey, I mean, you're doing something that, Ovi might struggle with. You know what I mean? And I think that was it was just when I first saw it, I was like, "Oh my God." Like I was blown away. When we first posted it on our website, I think it went semi-viral and we got like tens of thousands of views just for it. It was amazing because again, it's like, Banzai travels out to out to where you are, and you don't expect to see that talent out there. And when you do, it's eye-opening, And like I said, it's like they called it hockey is for everyone while you're here, almost to the point where it's a cliche, but it's really true. It's just, if I have a child that's female in the future or anything like that, I can show them this video and be like, yes, you could be a really great hockey player. Just because you're a woman, that doesn't mean you can't do whatever you want, And I think there was just a lot of meaning in it beyond you just doing a stick handling move. And Banzai, just as a player, he's just like you, a very, very sweet person. And the magic happened because of both of you, who you are as people, I think. So, not to embarrass you, but it really, really was amazing. And I'm really, really glad the Capitals reached out to you because just the whole thing was amazing for me, just as a fan of the team,
Like from my side, I even showed my brother afterwards. I'm like, did you see anything special in this video? He's like, nope, you do this all the time. So it's nothing special back home to my team or to anyone. It's just something they know I like to play with the puck and just fool around with it. So I was impressed that that's something somewhere else. Like, I don't know what to say.
Like I think also too is and I know I don't want to talk about politics too much because politics is not fun, especially right now, especially in my country. But there are a lot of people in America who are diverse, who celebrate that diversity. And, you know, again, it's very emotional and powerful just to see what happened, especially in a time with our country. You know, I thought that was the most amazing part, and I kind of tried to hint at it when I wrote posts about you that week, was that, you know, that weekend right before you arrived, there was a travel ban to the 7 Muslim-majority countries. And, you know, here you are, a mile away from the White House, getting a standing ovation basically from 18,000 fans. It basically shows that our country is maybe going in 2 different directions, but the people, you know, a lot of people are very supportive to everyone, that this country is built on, different ethnicities, different religions, different everything. We're not scared of different people, you know? And so I think that was probably the coolest part to me, is that, you know, you arrived during a time where at a lot of airports, there was protests, you know? Just about this silly thing that was happening.
My brother was kind of freaking out going there. So when I asked him about his visa, and, like, he took his passport, 1 day before he left. And we were afraid that he won't get it on time because of what's going on. And he's like, I'm kind of freaking out of what's going there. I told him it's just media. Nothing is happening. I talked to the embassy and everything is fine. Everyone is okay. Like, nothing is happening. And we're lucky here that we have the clearance in Abu Dhabi. So we don't have to do any clearance in the U.S. So we just finished everything from here, arrived there, and then just pick up our bag and just leave. So it was a really easy trip for us from here.
That's good. But, you know, the thing that makes me sad is that your brother even had to worry about that. You know what I mean?
Because he was just watching the news, and I was asking people who are living there. So that was the difference between me and him. Like, I like to ask and check about everything before going. So I don't have to worry about anything.
As does my wife, which is great, because if she didn't, I would never pay bills on time. We'd have no electricity at my house. So it's good that someone in your family is very nuanced and can be on top of details. But, like, I like being able to provide that context because, you know, on top of, you know, everything you symbolize from a hockey point of view, I think for a lot of people, you symbolized a lot more, especially that week. And, you know, in our country, there's a lot of crazy things happening. Like, you know, there's protests every week. It's been a very odd couple months in our country, and it was nice to see you so warmly received. I mean, I got mad when I saw some of the tweets that some crazy people sent you that I assume you probably saw too, which I reported.
Like, someone reached to me. I don't remember from which. Like, through Instagram, someone reached to me. He's like, I posted something about you, and sorry for the negative things that he's been saying. I told him that it's fine with me. Everyone have their own opinion. Everyone have their own thing. So it doesn't bother me. Like, I don't care. You have your own opinion, whether you like it or not. Like, it won't affect me.
And that's a really beautiful message, too. That, you know, if people want to focus on stupid stuff, it's, you know, we're just going to keep moving and be positive. So,
exactly.
I guess I should probably aim us back to hockey a little bit. So that day that you actually went to practice, I know that they got you a custom jersey and you went on the ice and you played with the players. What was that like for you too, you know, even before the big game where you got introduced to the crowd?
Actually, the biggest thing was meeting Ovi. So once I got over that nervousness, so everything calmed down. So even going on the ice, Peter asked me, like, are you okay? So I told him, I'm just nervous. Like, you're going with NHL players on the ice. Like, this is insane. I'm back home. I used to go with the men's, then they stopped me. They're like, you're not allowed to go with the men's on the ice. Just even for 5 minutes, I was, like, pissed off back home because I cannot go on the ice with them anymore. And then here I am in the U.S. going on the ice with NHL players. So how crazy is that? So I was just calm down, don't fall on your face, you can do it. They told me just to choose a stick. So like, oh my god, the stick is not suitable for me. It's too stiff. I have the wrong curve. I'm not used to like any of those sticks. So I just looked like which one is the most closest curve to the one I use. So Oshi was the closest. So I was like, okay, I'm picking this stick. And then we just went to the bench and were watching. And if you see my brother, every time he's turning to me and he's trying to joke around, it just reminded me to breathe. Just like, keep a smile on your face. And I was just shocked when I got to the ring, because they told me that, I told them I don't want any interviews, I don't want any cameras, I don't want to do any interviews. And then suddenly you get to the ring, expecting two cameras, and there's a dozen, more than a dozen cameras in your face. And Mike's like, oh my god, this is not happening. It's too much.
I think I told you this in DMs, but that was the most media that has come to Caps practice all year. For you.
Oh,
for
my god.
You.
That's insane.
And to be honest, one of the reasons why I did want to reach out to you, your English was so good. Like every interview that I saw you in, you handled yourself so very, very well. Better than I would have. So I need to constantly remind you that. I mean, it really was very impressive. I think it was funny. I was eating one night, that night after you practiced, and I was turning it on several different news stations when they do their news at night, and you were on every single station at the same time.
Yeah, the next day everyone around like saw me. Like, we saw you on the news. We saw you on the. Oh my god, that was quick.
I think you were on the front page, by the way, of like the Toronto Star or something, like the newspaper.
Yeah, I saw on Trump's face right beside me, so I was like, oh, I'm on the same page as you.
You need to frame that along with your jersey behind you.
It's the best jersey I have. It's all signed with the players.
Oh, that is so cool. Did they give that to you last week?
Yeah, I asked them to sign one jersey, and then they got me this one too, so I have now two jerseys.
Oh, that's
awesome.
I'm
glad I have two. Everyone is jealous. It's like, give us one. I'm like, no, that's mine. Nobody's touching that.
That is so cool. So I know when you were on the ice, you what do you remember from on the ice that was really fun?
Actually, I remember everything happened on the ice. I cannot forget any moment. Ovi coming to pick me up from the bench. That's insane. Who comes pick up someone from the bench? I thought the coach would come call me to go on the ice. Then I see Ovi coming toward me. I'm like, wow, this is amazing. And then the players coming toward me, offering their sticks to try it. I think they were jealous because I took Oshi's stick.
That's so funny. I don't know, you were doing some, you were kind of puck juggling with Evgeny Kuznetsov, who is a magician himself.
Yeah. I didn't think I could keep up. Like, I don't do this much with the players because our players, they cannot do that. They cannot juggle the puck. So it was like, I was happy that someone can do that with me. Like, oh, someone can play with me with juggling the puck. That was fun. I enjoyed it.
Yeah, it was
the Dick one timer with the legend one timer.
That was really cool. I remember, I think, wasn't it Nate Schmidt in the corner who went down to his knee and was like celebrating?
Yeah, that was him. That was Nate.
That was really, really funny. It's just, the whole thing was just so amazing. I could listen to you talk about it for 10 hours, and I don't want to keep you for 10 hours.
That's fine. So, weekend. I'm okay.
All right. Well,
as much as I want.
I did want to ask you a few other things, just more about like yourself and just basically how you first got into hockey. So I guess that's the first question, just right there, is you know, how did you first get exposed to hockey in Abu Dhabi, and you know, how did you first fall in love with it?
Do you know the Mighty Ducks movie?
Oh yes, oh yes! I watched them as a kid when I was like six.
Exactly, that started the whole thing.
Oh wow!
So I was watching those movies, and I think MVP, if you remember, the monkey.
Oh my God. you saw that? I didn't see that one. That was too bad of a movie, even for me.
It was hockey. I didn't care. It was hockey. They had ice. They had hockey. First of all, I started skating when I was 7, and I just taught myself how to skate. Nobody taught me how to skate. So I just took it step by step till I learned how to skate, and then I stopped for a while because nobody took me to the rink. So I was just watching hockey movies by then. And then in 2008, I was 18 by then, we went to the mall and saw a brochure of UAE have a hockey team and they're playing in a tournament. I turned to my mom, how come we have hockey in this country? I don't know about it. I have to go watch this. You have to take me there. So I went home the next day, took my camera and went to take photos of the games.
Yeah.
And one of the management after the game is like, who are you taking photos for? I'm like, I'm taking it for myself. So they told me, like, come and take photos for us. Like, at least we're going to use it instead of just keeping it for yourself. So I told them, okay, it's fine. Then the next year, they established the club, the Abu Dhabi Storms. And then the year after, 2010, they established the ladies team. And wow. I didn't join straight away. Like, I loved the game. I enjoyed every moment of it, watching the guys playing, stepping on the ice. Every game they go, every tournament, I was with them. And then they told me to join the ladies team. I'm like, they can't even skate. I'm not joining them. I can't skate. They cannot. So they went in May to a tournament in Hong Kong, and they were barely standing on their skates. So I'm like, I'm not going to go embarrass myself. So after they left, I asked the management to give me equipment and gears so I can start playing. And by then, the team was gone. So the only people I can practice with were kids, and they were under 9, actually even under 7.
Oh, wow.
So that's half of my size and looking up to me. Like, I still have the picture of my first practice. They're looking up to me, like, what is she doing here on ice with us? I'm practicing here as you guys. Like, you're not supposed to be here. So I talked to the coach. I'm like, watch your kids. Let me do my thing. And then I think that weekend we had two coaches from Finland doing a camp in another city in Al Ain. That city's in the desert. So I asked the coaches. It was for kids, U15, U12. I told the coaches, like, can I join the camp? I just want to learn more about the game. So they said, okay, yeah, sure. And the kids were making fun of me. It's like, ah, you can't even skate. You can't shoot the puck. So I'm like, okay, you will see one day who will be better than you. That was kind of a motivation for me to get better. And then I've been playing since then, 2011 and till now.
Wow. And you've gotten so good since then.
Yeah, there are a lot of motivation, so many people to piss off and prove them.
I'm very impressed by your will to, you know, a lot of people, when they get made fun of or teased or, you know, they will sometimes, especially in sports, not even want to play, you know. I know my wife, for instance, when she was in middle school, for instance, you know, she'd have to do gym, and kids would make fun of her. And even to this day, she kind of has, like, a fear of catching. So for you to be like, oh, these little kids, I'm going to show them. I mean, I think that's a really great personality trait and thing that people can admire from you, is that, you know, you didn't let anything stop you. You know, you had this joy and this interest in the sport, and you just went after it, which is really, really cool. One thing I wanted to...
I've been into a lot of trouble back home, like, just wanting to be on the ice. I got into so much trouble.
Like, explain that.
Like, I want to be on the ice most of the time. Sometimes I stayed, like, late till all the men's team get out of the ice. Then I jump on the ice the last half an hour or just 45 minutes or till they turn off the lights.
Yeah.
So just being on the ice for the last, even for 5 minutes, I just wanted to be on the ice. And I was struggling to be in the, we have a like a B league,
mm-hmm.
And it's like most of them are like beginners, and they have different levels. So I was better than some of the players over there, at least they can skate, and some of them, they can't even skate. So I was struggling just to join them. They're like, oh, we're going to hurt you, you're going to get injured, you're going to sue us, you're a girl, blah, blah, blah. So, like, I'm not going to sue anyone, I just want to play the game. So it's hockey. Anyone can get injured, anyone can get hurt. It doesn't matter if you're a girl or a guy.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's the thing. And then the first, I still remember, they put me for tryouts just to let me be on the ice. And my first incident, we had like one guy, he used to play in the NHL, and his nickname is Big Mike.
Mm-hmm.
And he's a big guy. And I crashed into him. It's like a cartoon. Boom! Back on my head. And he was just standing over my head. He's like, are you okay? And I was laughing. I'm like, I'm okay, just go play. I'll get up now. So, it's hockey. You will get hit, you will fall down, you get shot by the puck. Hockey's hockey.
Yeah, that's right. Like you were a referee, and apparently I read that you got punched in the face. It was no big deal, right?
I got shot in the face with a puck last season, so...
Yeah, no big deal.
It's not a big deal.
Yeah, whatever. I mean, one time I was at Caps practice, and a shot went over the net, and it hit me in the head and then my iPad. But I was fine.
Oh.
I was fine. I'm tough. I don't even need a helmet. I have a head so big. So I wanted to ask you, too. So what's the symbolization behind the number 7 that you wore? Is there anything, or you just like the number?
No, it's because when I started watching hockey back home, our best player was wearing number 7. So that was before even discovering Ovi.
Oh, wow.
And so he was the best player we had, and he was the scorer of the team, the captain, and the leader of the team. So from there, I picked up that number. And luckily, it was free because everyone was fighting on that number. It's a big it's a big thing, number back home. So I was lucky to find it. And number 8 was already taken by our captain. So I was lucky to find at least a number.
Or, you know, maybe you could just say that you're little Ovi because you're number 7. You're right one below him.
Yeah, that's another answer.
Yeah, that's one way to look at it, you know? I'll try to see what else. I don't even know what to say beyond all this. I'm trying to think what else. Oh, some of our readers have asked us, and this might blow you away too. A lot of our readers want to follow you and watch your games if there are any that are televised in the future. So they wanted me to ask you that.
Unfortunately, even our games are not filmed. Otherwise, I would have put a link. Saturday, I have a game. That's, I think, our first preparation game for the national team.
Yeah.
I'm freaking out regarding this. I want to reach to one of the players. How do they calm themselves down, before any game? I don't know if it's going to... No, this game is not going to be on TV. But we have a tournament next month from 7th till 16th of March in Thailand.
Oh, wow.
That one might be, I think might be live on online or something. I think. I hope so.
If it is.
Because it's under the IHF.
If it is, will you do me the favor of sharing the link? And I will make a post on RMNB, and we'll put it out there so people can. And if you ever want to, want to make a public Facebook page, you could do a Facebook Live. And stick your phone, if it has good enough reception in the rink, you could put it in the penalty box area.
I told my brother if he can be there to take photos of the game, so maybe I'll give him my phone and try to stream at least part of it on Instagram or something. So
that would be so cool.
I'll try to figure out something.
Yeah, that'd be really cool. I you really do. I say this sincerely: is you have a ton of fans now. And I'm just trying to get them to you.
That's insane.
It is. Well, I guess there's only really one last thing. All right, so let's see if I can make this pretty cool. I'm not as nearly as prepared as you were. All right, let's see. Let's see. All right, if you were. Awesome. Okay, well, I hope, you know, you have a wonderful weekend. And again, thank you so much for your time. It was so nice to meet you.
No problem, anytime.
All right,
and
cool.
It's great. Just stay in touch. We'll stay in touch.
Absolutely. All right, bye, Fatima.
Bye, thank you.
You're welcome. Bye.